My name is Abhijit Dhane.
And I am Nishan Shishodia.
We are from River Jhelum.
Jhelum.
So let me ask you one question. How many of you aware about the renewable energy? And how many of you know specifically companies which are operating in the wind technology?
Which are producing renewable energy? Anyone?
SUZLON. Yes, correct.
Yeah.
So today we are having a topic, downfall of the SUZLON. Next. So why this topic? Basically, I am an electrical engineer and he is a mechanical engineer. We both are very fascinating about the renewable energy sources which are there, and also SUZLON has gone from various ups and downs. So we can learn a lot of things by studying the case of SUZLON.
Downfall of SUZLON, yes. This is the vision of SUZLON: be the best renewable energy company in the world, create a better life for future generation. And their mission is deliver utility scale, best in class and end-to-end integrated renewable energy solutions to our customer. Here is a video.
By the year 2050, it'll be too late for them.
Here is the content which will be go through during the presentations. Introduction, rise of SUZLON, wind farm setup, SUZLON's FCC big crisis, reasons for downfall of SUZLON, revenue, and then conclusion. Here is the introduction. The founder of SUZLON is Tulsi Tanti. He established this industry in 1995, and its headquarters is in Pune, Hadapsar. The global workers are 10,000 plus. And the R&D setup are available in 4 countries: Germany, Denmark, the Netherlands, and India. Rise of SUZLON. Actually, Tulsi Tanti had a family business of textiles, but due to the electricity problems at that time and the high cost of the electricity, they were facing a huge problems. That's why he thought to build a plant, to install a plant windmill in their premises, which diverted them from their family business to SUZLON. In 1995, they formed an initial venture with SUZLON Energy Germany. Then in 2001, they looked towards the international market and established their subsidiary in North America. In 2005 and 6, they opened the IPO of 2.87 crore shares, which raised their funds by 1.466 crores. Then in 2006, acquires the Hensel Transmission International Belgium International Company from Belgium for rupees 2500 crores. Then in 2007 and 9, buy RE Power Systems, now it is known as Senvion, from Germany at a cost of 10,500 crores. Here's a wind setup of SUZLON in India. There are 5 wind farms in Jaisalmer, Kutch, Dhule, Eastern Ghat, and Satara.
So let me ask you one question. How many of you know aware about the FCCB term? So I think nobody is aware. So FCCB basically stands for Foreign Currency Convertible Bonds. These are the bonds which are different from regular bonds. Foreign currency means company raises its money from in the terms of foreign currency. And also convertible bonds means investor has 2 options. They can take their money after the maturity period of FCCB bonds with interest, or they can go for the equity share options. They can buy the shares of the company. So SUZLON has also wanted to expand its operation in India. That's why they have raised FCC bids. Through that, they have raised around 2,100 crore rupees in 2007. The maturity period was 5 years, but after maturity period has reached in May 2012, SUZLON was not able to repay its loans. It has defaulted FCC bids. Because of that, in 2013, bond lenders have forced SUZLON to go for corporate debt restructuring. After restructuring in January 2014, SUZLON was liable for paying 4,000 crore rupees to the bond lenders. Then till May 2019, around 1,800 crore worth FCC bids has been converted into equity shares. And yesterday only, there was a news of SUZLON. Principal value of SUZLON outstanding FCC bid was around 1,200 crore. Next. So why this downfall has happened? Such a big international company. So the first, the most reason was the 2008 global crisis. Crash of Lehman Brothers financial services has led to the global crisis of liquidity. That's why this has affected SUZLON also. SUZLON was not having any customer, or they were having stock in their inventory. And again, the next main reason for the downfall of SUZLON is the order cancellation by Edison Mission Energy. So this company has ordered basically 300 wind turbines from the SUZLON, but because they have defected some problem in the wind turbines, there was the cracks in the wind turbines. That's why they have cancelled the whole deal. This has cost around 700 crore rupees to the SUZLON. Then their debt funded international strategy. So SUZLON has gone international in the year 2001. After that, they have acquired a lot of companies in the US and Europe market. But this acquisition were led by they have raised fund by using loans. But how they are going to repay the loan, that strategy was not with them. So that is the main reason for their downfall. And also, as we discussed, it has default on redemption of FCC bids. Again, the SUZLON has neglected the Indian market. During that time, SUZLON was focusing on the global market. But at the same period, Indian market was also emerging, and global players such as General Electricals, Siemens, GEMSA, were investing a lot of money in the Indian market. That's why they have taken place of the SUZLON, and SUZLON was not able to grow that much in the Indian market. And also, there was a more supply than the demand. That's why tariff rates of the electricity from wind has also reduced. So it has reduced from 3.5 units per unit to 2.44 per unit.
This is the revenue in Indian market. As you can see, there is an ups and downs in revenue of the SUZLON. In 2017 fiscal year, their revenue was 9,646.65 crores, and in 2018 fiscal year, their revenue declined to 6,535 crores. Here's a reason how they minimize their debt. In 2012, they sold their Hansen Transmission International Company with a profit of 900 crores. After that, in 2015, they sold their Sanvian to a Cambridge Partners of America for 7,200 crores. In 2015, Dilip Sanghvi purchased 23% of the stakes of the company at a cost of 1,800 crores. In 2015, investment by DSA, Dilip Sanghvi Association, of INR 400 crores for the setup of 400 megawatt wind farm. In 2008, they sold their stakes in the Chinese market
So in the conclusion, so what had this downfall has happened? But the SUZLON has established itself as a global player from its 1995 operation started. In 2001 it has gone global. So it is a major player in the global market. Also, depth expansion strategy was the major cause of the downfall. Thank you.